May 9th, 2021. Amazon bestsellers. Let's look through and see if there's any Star Wars books here. Number 36, Thrawn Ascendancy. Number 37, The Heart of the Jedi. 37 positive reviews, 5 stars. Let's take a look. Page not found. This was removed early this morning and is no longer available on the Amazon storefront. Fortunately, I bought a copy over a week ago. It is unclear as to why it has been removed. Most likely, Disney Lucasfilm has claimed a copyright on the book to Amazon. Naturally, that is the excuse that they will use. What they won't tell you is that they removed the book because it is outranking all of their other books, in particular, all of the High Republic media. Let's see if we can find the High Republic. Not in the top 50. Is there even another Star Wars book in the top 100? There is not. A book from 1992 that never got published and now was released just about a month ago has received massive support from Star Wars fans in general, and in particular, EU fans. The book has been selling a lot of copies and has outranked everything that Disney is producing at the moment. Just a few days ago, the book was ranked much higher, and that is why Disney Lucasfilm has removed it. They don't want you to see what real Star Wars fans actually want. Real Star Wars. As you can see here, I just came back to the page and it is completely gone from the marker. I have heard reports from many other YouTube creators that the book was in the top 10. The highest ranked I had seen it at was number 26 on May 5th, 2021. Now it has dropped naturally as they have removed the book. So let's find out about the history of this book, why it wasn't published, and why it ended up here. The History of Heart of the Jedi and How It Didn't Get Published by Kenneth C. Flint. In 1991, I was making my living as an author. I was writing 2 books a year for Spectra, the sci-fi fantasy imprint of Bantam, Doubleday, Dell. I'd had 12 books published, with a 7-book backlist and a 1,000,000 books in print. I had just signed a new 2-book contract with Spectra, with titles to be decided later. Then I got an exciting letter from my editor. Because of the success of a hardcover Star Wars trilogy by Timothy Zahn, Lucasfilm had asked Spectra to publish an additional series of paperbacks. Spectra had searched through its stable for suitable authors, sending copies of our works to Lucasfilm for selection. My books were Celtic-based, sword and sorcery, but my City series books were a fantasy, sci-fi combination, and a review of Riders of the City said it has enough derring do for at least one Lucasfilm. Apparently George Lucas thought so too, because I was told he had personally selected me to do a Star Wars book. Even better, I would be writing book one of the proposed series, taking place immediately after the second Death Star is destroyed. Note, this would have been followed by Margaret Weiss's Legacy of Doom, with both books to be preceded by Jim Baikie's Exiles of the Force 4-part comic book miniseries from Dark Horse Comics. Weiss later stated that she'd had a disagreement with Lucasfilm and Baikie's series was canceled. Being a crazy big Star Wars fan, I saw the first movie 7 times in the theater and drank my coffee from a Star Wars mug. You can imagine how thrilled I was. I was given pretty much free rein on developing my plot. Other than that, it should take place immediately after the second Death Star is destroyed. I upfront figured it would be most logical to deal with a defeated but not destroyed Empire, its military desperately trying to regroup and retaliate against the Alliance, while other elements sought to make peace. Along with this was my assumption that I had to deal with what Luke Skywalker had become and where he was going as a Jedi. I spent the first months developing an outline and submitted it to my editor. I want to make the point here that I never, throughout all of this, communicated directly with Lucasfilm people or knew who they were. I worked for Spectra and everything came through my editor. But I was told, and very honored to hear, that George Lucas himself had approved my plot, with one specific alteration. I had shown sand people without their masks, and he said, that must never happen. I spent most of the next year writing that book, putting my own books aside. My primary sources were the movies themselves, which I watched over and over, often in slow-mo, and a Star Wars source book for game players from West End Games that Lucasfilm supplied. By the end of 1992, I had a draft ready. I sent it in and waited, and waited. While I inquired as to how it was going, my editor said that the process of the Star Wars project had stalled as they developed the rest of the series, and she still had to go through it herself before sending it to Lucasfilm for their assessment. I believed her. Why not? I finally got a list of mostly minor stuff and started revisions. After more months passed, I heard from my editor that things were moving ahead again with the Star Wars project. I finished my revisions and submitted it. Again, I was told the Lucas people approved it. In fact, they said they quite liked it. Then I waited. Yet more months went by. I heard nothing. I didn't think I needed one, as I'd always dealt directly with Spectra and been fairly treated. Finally, growing concerned, I contacted an agent who contacted Spectra. He discovered only then that Spectra had determined my book couldn't be published because it no longer fit into the sequence for the new series. I was told that this had happened because of my Spectra editor. She had supposedly promised an other author of the group, a friend of hers, according to one source, that her book would be placed in position 1. This apparently accounted for the delays that I had been told about. While she wrote her own book to slip into my slot, while I sat idle and ignorant of what was happening for months, I have made a point of not knowing who this other author is, and I have never been able to bring myself to read her book or any other of the subsequent series, saddened that this so violated my love of everything Star Wars. Did I confront Lucasfilm and try to fight the situation? Nope. I didn't know who to contact or how. Remember, I worked for Spectra. I had no resources of my own. I was pitifully naive, and I felt pretty much powerless by that point. Oh, they graciously let me keep the $10,000 advance, and they threw me a bone letting me still do 2 Star Wars short stories for Tales from the Jabba's Palace and Tales from the Mos Eisley Cantina. But I was done otherwise. None of my own books came out as the debacle went on. I would normally have published 4 new ones during this time. I lost my backlist of Irish books. Because of the long delay, my family pretty much lived on my advance for 2 years, on exception of the eventual payday from the Star Wars book. This basically destroyed my relationship with Spectra and my career as a writer. I felt completely betrayed, and I was so depressed that I quit writing for years. Needing money to support my family with 2 young sons, I found a job as a publications consultant, meaning tech writer, and, after another 10 years, finally made up the financial loss of being all but unemployed for 2 years. Finally, nearing 60 years old and with the boys both adults and employed, I decided to semi-retire and work on a book idea that enthused me enough to try writing again, but not sci-fi or fantasy. It was to be a Civil War adventure with a Jules Verne-esque plotline that had a band of Confederate agents trying to save the South by destroying Washington, D.C. with the world's first weapon of mass destruction. It would be called Nitro. I went back to teaching as an English department adjunct for the University of Nebraska at Omaha, my alma mater, and got the book written. I then discovered that, nowadays, an author of fiction can't even submit a book to a publisher without going through an agent. I searched for an agent for a couple of years, but found no one. It seems that unless they are sure they can sell a specific book of yours, they won't handle you. I guess that seems fair, and I had been out of the business, by my own choice, a long time. But then I got a new chance. An online publisher agreed to put out all my old novels as ebooks. He also published my new book, now called Ironclad. I've written other things too, since then. My family does living history at the reconstructed 1820s frontier outpost called Fort Atkinson near Omaha. I started a series of historical novels based at the place, and got a history book of the fort published through Arcadia. So my old fans can still find my books through Amazon. But, man, I'd love to get Ironclad put out as a physical book, and I still have ideas for other fantasy, sci-fi, and horror plots, plus the 20 or so other Celtic Irish books I'd still like to write. I think I've got at least a few viable years of authorship in me. So, if anybody knows of somebody who'd like to represent me, I am ready to start writing 2 books a year again. Otherwise, I'm quite content teaching some writing classes and being the school time daycare for my 2 grandsons, age 4 years and 1 year. The book is a really great story with 435 pages. Throughout the book, you can see there are ideas that modern-day Disney Lucasfilm has taken for projects like The Mandalorian. Page 6, The Heart of the Jedi. Nothing happened, but in the next instant, the door was gone, blown inward by a compact but efficient explosion that rent it to flaring debris and sent smoke billowing forward, filling the corridor. The Imperials winced back from the blast, but stood stalwartly fast, peering through the pall of smoke into the new blackness behind the ragged opening. Figures appeared there, only vague shadows at first. One move forward, the first defenders, the stormtroopers, began to fire, their bolts angling into the roiling gray. In response, an odd, angry buzzing sound suddenly arose. At the same time, a short, green beam of light came into being, one figure sweeping it around within the smoke, swinging out to parry the blaster shots with astounding speed, sending them bouncing away. The trooper stared, ceased firing, momentarily nonplussed. In the brief lull, the one figure acted, rushing forward from the smoke into full view. It was a man in jet black uniform, a helmet with lowered blast visor over his head. He leaped swiftly and agilely into the first rank of the waiting troopers. The long blade of green light he held swung about from side to side with great swiftness and unerring aim, drawing glowing arcs in the hazy air, crackling with power as it struck opponents, slashing some foes down, throwing the rest into panic. So between the fact that this book was outranking all of their current books, and they didn't want people to discover that they're taking things from that book, they have naturally taken it down from Amazon. Disney is also well known for not wanting to pay their authors. I just refreshed the page, and now The Heart of the Jedi is completely gone from Amazon. It was here at number 37. StarWarsTimeline.net. I will leave the link in the description. Here's an outline of how this book was recently published on Amazon. The long-lost novel, commissioned and approved by Lucasfilm and set to be released in 1993, disappeared without a trace. For many years, fans wondered what became of the book and why it was never published, and so it was chalked up to yet another tragic Lost World story that no one would ever get to read or enjoy. Or so we thought. Kenneth C. Flint's complete novel, The Heart of the Jedi, has at last been unearthed. Published here in 4-chapter installments, it has been edited to fit into the existing expanded universe, taking place a short time after the truce at Bacara and the end of issue number 107 of the Marvel series, but before the X-Wing comic book series. The Heart of the Jedi. Darth Vader and the Emperor are no more. The Alliance has officially become the New Republic. As Han Solo, Princess Leia, and new Chief of State Mon Mothma emerge triumphant against the diminishing Empire, the Imperial Remnant fights on until the long, silent Imperial Senate rises up to call for peace. But not everyone wants peace, and High Admiral Tharkus has made plans to ensure the Empire will reemerge under his rule. At his side stands the mysterious Dias Kororri, beings of rare and deadly power. For Luke Skywalker, exhausted from years of fighting, the time has come to depart upon a journey of discovery, a journey that will lead him to a secret long ago hidden by Obi-Wan Kenobi. On this page, you can read the chapters, here are the links, here is the bio of the author, some behind the scenes, editing notes, and there is a PDF of the book. And you can scroll down and read the entire book here on this webpage. Here is the PDF. So you can very easily download it and have a copy. You can also print it from here. Keep in mind that the PDF only has 376 pages of the story. The book itself is 435 pages. You could download or print the PDF, or you can, of course, from this webpage, print out the entire book. I encourage you to check it out. It's a great story. It's real Star Wars, and it shows support for what the fans really want. Not High Republic nonsense, but real Star Wars. The link is in the description to the book. I hope you enjoy it, and be sure to remind Disney Lucasfilm that this is what you want, not rocks and Borg plants. This book was released in paperback on Amazon.com on March 4th, 2021, and has now been removed on April 9th, 2021. So it lasted about a month and a half. The main thing is that it got a bunch of awareness. It sold like crazy and got nothing but positive reviews, and it outranked everything that Disney Lucasfilm is doing today. Be sure to get a copy, be sure to talk about it, and let Disney know what we want. Please like, subscribe, and comment on the video. May the Force be with you.